Because I'm beautiful.
This is why we're all in therapy.
Happy New Year to everybody. Everybody's getting dressed. I'm just going to sit here and do nothing. Nothing.
It's morning.
We don't go together.
I already picked that one out for Joey.
We don't go together.
And this is for JC. And this is you. I don't know.
I like that.
This is how you make a video. You put on shoes.
And they're only $530 for a pair of pants. All right.
It's a good thing we giving these back. I can't afford it.
It was cool. It was cool. It was a lot of fun. When we first thought of the idea, everybody was like, yeah, this is going to be really cool. And I was like, you guys are weird. Running on trains, cars, and dogs. And I was like, it's a dude video. And it's like video for guys. It's what we like. Trains, cars, chicks, and dogs. I don't know about trains, but cars, chicks, and dogs we like. Trains is just thrown in because me and Joey didn't have anything to do. Let's put them on a train. Great idea. I was scared to death.
Joey got a big old butt.
Oh, you know what told you I'd be true.
Yeah.
Joey got a big old butt. So I'm leaving. This doesn't work. This fell apart.
No, it didn't.
It only takes you an hour to get your arm through each and every one of these little
Let me give you some
funny things.
For God's sakes.
Hey, we need these pants. Darren, Darren.
What's the matter? He wants it still. Okay.
You know what? You can grab him right here. Come here!
Do the choreography to a song, you know, according to what sound it has. And our sound is just taking on a certain edge that is new. So we wanted to put in some new, tight, harder choreography. So that's what it is. It is what it is.
Energy. Like I said, the album is all energy.
You asked me to do that and it looks like this. It looks like this going off like this.
Is this how it goes?
Go, go, Joey!
Go, Joey! Go home.
It's a birthday!
Yeah. He has real funny dance steps to do. I'm gonna make him
you do, it
do stuff like that.
Let's try
I'm
this.
Feeling this.
Are you?
Come in here for a second. Let me show you how clean we all are.
Yo, that was not me. I didn't do that.
Yeah. We keep a clean dressing room. Okay, get out.
Okay, we're on the set of Bye Bye Bye, and we are in a room that actually rotates, which gives you the look of walking on the ceiling and walking on the walls and, you know, kind of a weird, tripped out look on the TV as far as people are concerned. It's going to throw them off a little bit, you know? Don't.
For a while, I'll get to go out with my friends and go back into Brooklyn and stuff like that and hang out and, you know, just hang out, relax, and see, you know, I haven't seen a bunch of people. Every once in a while, I run into other people that I haven't seen that I used to go to Catholic school with, like in first, second grade. So it's pretty cool. It's interesting just to see people, and they look kind of, they look at you kind of weird, like, okay, is that really still him? Has he changed? Still the same person, eh? What the heck am I going to change for?
You'll usually get in, everybody will say hi, everybody wants to hang out, you'll go out, you'll hang out with everybody, and then when you go to bed, you usually don't wake up until like 3 or 4 in the afternoon the next day, if it's your first day off or whatever. And then you get up, stretch out, and then go do something totally mellow that day. You maybe go see a movie, call up some friends, make sure you don't call everybody, because then all of a sudden there's a party at your place.
When I'm home, there's like 200 people in my house always, which I love because I love all my friends. And I mean, it's fun. They treat me no different from 10 years ago. They've all stayed the same. It's harder to go out to the mall, you know, because that's, you know, where some of the younger kids are. And my parents' house is hard to go to now because they're always in the front yard picking the grass or something like that. They fortunately don't know where I live yet.
We do everything for our fans that we possibly can. And that's why I think they see that and they stay by us.
We try to sign autographs as much as we can. And we try to, you know, do meet and greets. We do meet and greets before every show, before every concert. We do autograph signings and meet and greets.
Thank you.
Label, and I was new at the whole game, you know. I mean, even with in dance class and making a video, I didn't know anything. So when I came to the studio, I really kind of let other people not tell me what to do, but help me out. And I think if you were, not because I'm young, but I think if you were 28, you would have done the same thing. You know, it's just something that I had to experience and grow with.
I think the main thing he was interested in was the talking and the verses.
Right now we're just working on the song that Diane Warren wrote.
I get to talk.
This is Steve Lunt. He's my A&R guy. I've been with him for like a year and a half now. I cannot sing with my shoes on. If you make some noise, we're going to have to kick you out, all right?
Yeah. Tell him it's history.
Your history.
I love to hear you say that you love me.
I was way too loud to say that again. I'm sorry. I love the that was so low, okay. Got the giggles.
Yeah,
I love to hear you say that you love me.
It's hot laughing.
With words.
You're a sick person.
Actually, when I was on tour, I was always writing in my head and singing melodies in my head, and it was kind of intimidating at first because I was working with the most amazing songwriters in the world, and I didn't want to sing a melody to them and then be like, well, it's not that great. So that I started, like, all my best stuff that I would write, I would keep in my journal, and I would get melodies to them in my head, and I would call up the producers, do you like this? Does this sound okay? Or leave it on his voicemail at home, answer machine at home, and I would leave it, and he would be like, yeah, it's cool, and we'd see what we could do with it. So, and then one of the songs, it's going to be on the album, so I'm excited.
Well, first of all, we ought to start off with a traditional producer and engineer pose at the board, which we will now assume their position. This is what every photograph of every producer and engineer, this is what they do.
I love to hear you say that you love me.
I love to hear you say.
With words so sweet.
It's a lot lower.
And I love the way, with just one whisper, you tell me everything.
That's good. They sound good together, don't they?
I like it.
Yeah, I do too. I like it a lot.
I like it a lot.
Okay. Off to MTV.
Mm-hmm. Now we're going to get in it for a paycheck and doing her job. You know, it's not about that. I mean, they really enjoy their jobs and they love what they do. And that's important that you surround yourself with people that, you know, are cool like that.
All right, what's up, buddy? What's going on?
All right. No, I was looking forward to it.
We're going to go out during the next video, do the stand, and then, you know, they'll be like, hey, Brittany's here.
I'm about to go out to y'all. I have a lot of fun. And I look really goofy because I broke a nail. So I'm going to have to hide.
1 minute, Dave.
Stand by camera.
Okay.
Plus, Britney Spears is here. She's actually in her audio room right now, taking some phone calls. Let's check that out.
Hello. Yeah. Do you have a question for Britney Spears? Okay. Okay. Well, you can find out later. Okay.
These people have no idea. It's Britney answering the phone. All right. All that and more with DRL will return. Stick around.
So, I bet some of them knew that it was me or like.
No, they usually don't have a clue that it's you.
Watch it. This is Noah. It's really, really weird that my name is known all around the world. It's crazy, and it's really exciting, though. Video that I've done, all the concepts have always, you know, there's a lot of, I'm open to ideas, not that I'm not open to anyone else's opinion. I mean, if they come up with something better than me, then heck, I'll do it, you know. But most of the videos, like Baby One More Time, that was my idea, and actually the video that's probably going to be for the next album, the first single, will be my idea.
Hi, we're behind the scenes at Oops, the video. This is Nick, he's one of the dancers.
Paying my bills, because I'm always out with Britney Spears. She keeps us very busy.
This is Andre, he's sleeping. And this is our shoulder. This is where we get our makeup and hair done. Come on. No one's in here, but I'll let you.
Hi. You're late, everyone's done.
Let's go. Come on.
It's basically about these astronauts, and they're trying to go to planet Mars, and they go there to find that it's kind of like Britney rules Mars or something, and like you know, control of the whole Mars thing.
I'm Eli Swanson, aka the astronaut boyfriend type person.
Taking a slack up.
Okay, watching me, Eli, watching me.
Very good. And now coming down.
He gets there and then he meets me, and when he takes his helmet off or whatever, he normally, you know, you don't have any oxygen, so your head would explode or something like that. So, but he takes it off and he realizes he's fine because he's with me, of course.
This little side is crunched. I don't know why. So Dave, you step out. In the
to see the end product and you're like, oh, I made that up, that was my idea, and you actually see it on the TV. It's really, it's fun.
Thank you,
bye. I'm going home.
Why do you bring Wayne's
seat? I can't believe they did this before.
These pants are $530.
That's why I don't own them.
That's why you like them.
That's why I bought all this stuff at the Salvation Army.